हेलो स्टूडेंट, हाउ आर यू? आई एम डॉक्टर वर्षा भोसले। वी डिस्कस रही इन द लास्ट वीडियो ऑन टॉपिक ऑफ विच टॉपिक ऑफ एडम स्मिथ थ्योरी, थ्योरी ऑफ एब्सोल्यूट कॉस्ट एडवांटेज। सो स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन द सम थ्योरीज लाइक एज द नेम ऑफ थ्योरी ऑफ कंपेरेटिव कॉस्ट एडवांटेजेस एंड the comparative cost theory was first systematically formulated by the English economist who is the name of David Ricardo, English economics David Ricardo, David Ricardo in his principle of political economy and taxation, principle of political economy and taxation 1870. So it was later refined by Jess Mill, Marshall, F.W. Tocin and Gottfried von Hebler. So according to David Ricardo, it is not the absolute but comparative cost differences that determine trade relations between two countries. David Ricardo, according to it is not the absolute but comparative cost difference that determine trade relation between two countries. Due to differences in climate, nature, natural resources, geographical situation and efficiency labor, a country can produce one commodity at a lower cost than the other. In the way, each country specialized the production of the commodity in which comparative cost of production is the least. Therefore, when a country enters into trade with some other country, it will contract on the production of those goods and services in which it has the cost advantage and exchange them with the goods and services. So it means produced by the other countries for the production of which it was either less suited or had positive cost disadvantages. So listen and carefully student, the concept of comparative advantages also explain why a country is capable of producing a wide variety of goods and services at a lower cost than any other country should concentrate on producing that good or services for which its cost advantages is the greatest and leave the production of other goods in which it has a positive but less cost advantages to other country. So student, theory of comparative cost advantages. So according to David Ricardo, the basis of international trade is that each country will specialize in the production of those commodities in which it has the greatest advantages or the at least comparative disadvantages. म्हणजे इथं रिकॉर्डचा खर्च सापेक्ष किंवा लाभ सिद्धांत किंवा त्याला काय आपण म्हणतो तुलनात्मक खर्च लाभ सिद्धांत, तर रिकॉर्ड यांनी तुलनात्मक किंवा सापेक्ष सिद्धांत मांडून स्मिथ आणि त्यांच्या सिद्धांतामुळे एक महत्त्वाचं असं पाऊल टाकलं आहे की रिकॉर्ड यांचा सिद्धांत स्मिथ यांच्या सिद्धांतावर काय आहे अवलंबून आहे. कारण स्मिथच्या मते निरपेक्ष खर्चातील निरपेक्ष लाभामुळं आंतरराष्ट्रीय व्यापार होतो आणि मात्र रिकॉर्डचं मत काय की सापेक्ष खर्चातील तफावतीमुळं म्हणजेच सापेक्ष लाभामुळं आंतरराष्ट्रीय व्यापार होतो. म्हणजे एक देश सर्वच वस्तूच्या उत्पादनात दुसऱ्या देशाच्या तुलनेत जास्त कार्यक्षम असतील, म्हणजे एका देशात दोन्ही वस्तूचा खर्च दुसऱ्या देशातील खर्चापेक्षा काय होतो कमी असतो आणि तरीसुद्धा आंतरराष्ट्रीय व्यापारामध्ये दोन्हीही देशांचा लाभ मिळतो, म्हणजे त्यामुळंच आंतरराष्ट्रीय व्यापार हा होतो. नेक्स्ट assumption म्हणजे तुम्हाला सिद्धांत लक्षात आला असेल की इन अदर वर्ड आई सेड दॅट इन अदर वर्ड अ कंट्री विल एक्सपोर्ट दोज कम्युनिटीज इन विच इट्स कम्पॅरेटिव्ह ॲडव्हान्टेजेस इज द ग्रेटेस्ट अँड इम्पोर्ट दोज कम्युनिटी इन विच इज कम्पॅरेटिव्ह डिसॲडव्हान्टेजेस इज लिस्ट. सो assumption रिकॉर्ड अँड मिल हॅड assumptions रिकॉर्डो अँड मिल नेम ऑफ द मिल नेम ऑफ द इकॉनॉमिस्ट रिकॉर्ड अँड मिल हॅड डेव्हलप्ड द थेअरी ऑफ कम्पॅरेटिव्ह कॉस्ट ऑन सर्टन इम्पॉर्टंट assumption विच इज assumption. सो फर्स्ट इज द रिकॉर्डियन मॉडेल इज टू कंट्री टू कम्युनिटी. सेकंड इज थेअरी प्रोड्यूस द सेम टू कम्युनिटीज. थर्ड इज All labor was assumed to be homogeneous. And fourth, it assumed that there are no transportation charges. Trade between the two countries take place on the basis of barter system. International trade is free from all barriers and restrictions. And seven is, there is no disturbance from such source and trade cycle. And last, there is full employment of the factors of production in the two countries. म्हणजे इथं गृहिता आपल्याला काय सांगितलेले आहेत की दोन देश दोन वस्तूचं उत्पादन किंवा वाहतूक खर्चाचा अभाव मुक्त व्यापार नंतर दोन देशामध्ये उत्पादन घटक हा अगतिशील गतिशील नसणारा तो अगतिशील नंतर श्रम एक जिन्सी असतील नंतर वस्तूचं मूल्य हे श्रमाच्या एककात मोजलं जातं आणि पूर्ण रोजगार हा अस्तित्वात असतो. तर अशा पद्धतीनं हे गृहिते म्हणजेच अझम्पशन आहेत. तर नेक्स्ट रिकॉर्डियन मॉडेल. सो रिकॉर्डियन मॉडेल इज टू कंट्री अँड टू कम्युनिटी मॉडेल. टू कंट्रीज प्रोड्यूस होमोजिनियस गुड्स प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट इज ओनली लेबर कॉस्ट अँड देर इज ऑल लेबर इज होमोजिनियस नो ट्रान्सपोर्ट कॉस्ट प्रोडक्शन सब्जेक्ट टू कॉन्स्टंट कॉस्ट ट्रेड इज बेस्ड ऑन बार्टर सिस्टम अँड नेक्स्ट देर इज फ्री ट्रेड फुल एम्प्लॉयमेंट इन टू कंट्री नो इम्पॅक्ट ऑफ ट्रेड सायकल. दिस इज अ रिकॉर्डियन मॉडेल. दिस इज अ रिकॉर्डियन मॉडेल. सो स्टुडंट जेव्हा एखाद्या देशामध्ये दोन्ही वस्तूचा उत्पादन खर्च हा दुसऱ्या देशातील आणि त्या वस्तूच्या उत्पादन खर्चापेक्षा कमी असतो तरीसुद्धा दोनही देशांना व्यापारातून काय होतो लाभ मिळतो. तर हा लाभ कसा मिळतो हे आपण थ्री टाईप्स ऑफ कॉस्ट डिफरन्सेस. सो ॲप्सुलेट कॉस्ट डिफरन्सेस. फर्स्ट इज ॲप्सुलेट कॉस्ट differences. So Adam Smith's theory made Adam Smith argued that international trade is advantageous for all the participating country only if they enjoying absolute difference in the cost of production of the commodity in which they specialize. And second is equal differences. So there is equal differences in production cost. International trade cannot take place. There is hardly any possibility of profit in international trade when the equal differences in production cost between the two countries and international trade comes to an end. So last, comparative cost differences. Three types of cost differences. So last is comparative cost differences. So recorded shows that the trade is possible between two countries even when country has a absolute advantage in the production of both goods. But comparative advantage in the production of the commodity than in the other. Student, listen. We take the well-known example. As given by Ricardo to explain the theory comparative cost differences, it is a trade between two countries, Britain and Portugal. Britain and Portugal. So, two commodities, cloth and wine. And David Ricardo in his model of two country, two commodity world, pointed out the Portugal could produce both wine and cloth. This is Britain, Portugal, for example, both wine and cloth cheaper than Britain, but possess a great cost advantage in wine than in a cloth. Hence, it was in the interest of Portugal to concentrate on the production of wine, leave the produce of the cloth to Britain. So, this is country Britain and Portugal, and his production wine and cloth. So, wine and cloth, and this is Britain and Portugal. So, this table for producing 1 unit of wine in Britain in require 120 men for a year, and for 1 unit of cloth is require 100. This is 120 and cloth 100. The same period by contract, Portugal require producing the same quantity of the wine cloth 80 and 90. Same 80 and 90. So it makes clear a Portugal's labor it more efficiency than British labor in producing both the goods, wine and cloth. Other word, I explain the other word, Portugal process an absolute advantage in both wine and cloth. However, Portugal has more benefit in production of wine and exporting it to Britain, as it possess greater comparative advantages in it. And the cost of producing wine in Portugal 80 for example 80 upon 120 80 upon 120, so which is relatively lesser than the production cost of the cloth. So for example 90 upon 100, so 90 upon 100 manje ith व्यापार व्यापार करने म्हणजे व्यापारापूर्वीची स्थिती, तर प्रत्येक देश हे दोन्ही उत्पादन करतो, म्हणजे पोर्तुगल आणि देश हा दारू आणि कापडाचं उत्पादन करेल असं आपण इथं सांगितलेलं आहे. म्हणजे इथं ब्रिटन सुद्धा काय करतो, दारू आणि कापडाचं उत्पादन करतो. म्हणजे दोन देशातील अंतर्गत गुणोत्तर हे काय असतं, वेगवेगळं असतं. म्हणजे पोर्तुगलचं अंतर्गत गुणोत्तर काय केलेलं आहे आपण इथं 80 upon 120 is equal to 0.83. 0.83. And Britain अंतर्गत जे काही गुणोत्तर आहे ते आपण इथं काय केलेलं आहे, 100 upon 90. So तर इथं दोघांचं कंपॅरिझन जर केलेलं असेल, तर इन ब्रिटन द प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट ऑफ क्लॉथ 100 अपॉन मेन विच इज लेस दॅन कंपेर्ड टू वाईन 120 अपॉन मेन 120 अपॉन 80 मेन. द कंपॅरेटिव्ह कॉस्ट डिफरन्सेस इन द ट्रेड आर बेनिफिशियल टू बोथ द कंट्री. सो we are diagrammatical discussion. This is diagram, this is rough diagram. So this is wine TXBORS, this is cloth, and this is P and a y अक्ष. सो पी टी इज प्रोडक्शन पॉसिबिलिटी. पी टी इज दिस इज पॉइंट इज पी पी एंड दिस पॉइंट इज टी. दिस पॉइंट पी टी इज द प्रोडक्शन पॉसिबिलिटी कर्व ऑफ पोर्तुगाल. दिस कर्व इज पोर्तुगाल. And BR is Portugal has a absolute advantage in the production. BR means this, and this is BR, this line. So it produce OT of wine and OPE of cloth. OT, this OT is wine, and OP, this OP is cloth. Is that clear? So where Britain products are the wine and OB of cloth, O and B, this. The slope of ES, which is partial to PT, shows the Portugal has greater comparative advantages in the production of wine, because if Portugal devote the resource required to produce OB of cloth, it can produce OS of wine, which is still greater than OR of wine of Britain. OR, this is wine, and OB cloth. So PT shows that Portugal has the greater comparative advantages in the production of wine. Why? Because if Portugal devotes the resource required to produce OB of cloth, it can produce OS. This is OS. So we wine which is still greater than or wine of Britain. In contrast, Britain and the least comparative disadvantages in the production of OB of cloth. Therefore, Portugal with export of OS of wine to Britain, and in the exchange get OB of cloth from Britain. Is that clear? So म्हणजे अशा प्रकारे दोन्ही देशांना काय होतो, आंतरराष्ट्रीय व्यापारातून आपल्याला लाभ हा मिळतो, हे आपल्याला आकृतीद्वारे स्पष्ट झालेलं आहे. सो नेक्स्ट, क्रिटिकल इव्हॅल्युएशन, टीकात्मक परीक्षण. सो द फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड वॉर रिकॉर्ड ऑन प्रिन्सिपल ऑफ कंपॅरेटिव्ह ॲडव्हान्टेजेस हॅज बीन द व्हेरी बेसिस ऑफ इंटरनॅशनल ट्रेड. But after the First World War, crisis have been able only to modify it and amplify it. In Professor Samuelson's words, if theories like girls could win beauty contest, comparative advantages would certainly rate high in that it is illegitimately logical structure. The Ricardon theory is not free the defense and has been severely criticized in Bartle and Olin and Frank D. Graham's name of the discussed under which economics criticized Bartle, Olin and Frank D. Graham. So first is 20 model unrealistic. So this model unrealistic. So the Ricardon model is related to trade between two countries and two commodities. This is an unrealistic assumption, and international trade is between many countries and trading in the many commodities. And next is no free trade. So no free trade, a serious weakness of the doctrine is that it is based on the assumption of perfect and free world trade. But in reality, there is no free trade. In fact, every country applies restriction on the free movement of goods to and from other countries. Thus, tariff and many other trade restrictions affect import and export of the world. Further, the communities are not homogeneous but are differential. So, neglect not labor cost. Next critic, neglect not labor cost. So, an important criticism against the comparative advantages cost theory is it is based on the labor theory of value. That is a production cost and the only component that it include in its calculation is the labor cost and neglects non-labor cost involved in the production of commodities. This is truly under-realistic because it is money cost and non-labor cost that are the basis of national and international transaction of goods. So, next is similarly in test in the two countries. Similarly, test is a two country. So, the assumption of similar test is from reality because test different with different in income in the country. Manje, ja veles don desh ani don vastu हे रिकॉर्डने काय केलेला आहे विचार केला आहे प्रत्यक्षात व्यापारामध्ये अनेक देश असतात आणि अनेक वस्तूंचं उत्पादन हे होत असतं. नेक्स्ट इज नो ट्रान्सपोर्ट. नो ट्रान्सपोर्ट. सो रिकॉर्डिंग थेरी इग्नोर ट्रान्सपोर्ट कॉस्ट डिटर्मिनेशन कंपॅरेटिव ॲडव्हांटेजेस इज द इन द ट्रेड. सो स्टुडंट, दिस इज द अंडर रिअलिस्टिक अजम्पशन बिकॉज transport cost play a significant role in the determine the pattern of world trade. So similar to the economic of scale, it is an independent factor of production. For example, I said that high transport cost may actually wipe out of the out all the comparative cost advantages the country will enjoy and there may be no gains from international trade. So next is full employment. Next is full employment. So the most unrealistic assumption underlying all classical theory and Ricardo's theory of comparative advantages is the extent of full employment in the economy. This assumption drops the dynamic element of the from the theory and make it static. Keynesian falsified the assumption of full employment and proved that there is unemployment and unemployment existing in the economy rather than full employment. So next is self-interest as a hindrance. Self-interest in the hindrance. Hindrance means arthala. So the theory does not hold well if a country having a comparative disadvantages does not wish to import a commodity from the other country. The two strategic military or development considerations, and other word, very often it is a self-interest that stand in the operation of the theory of comparative cost. This is self-interest as hindrance. Incomplete theory. Next is incomplete critic theory. So Ricardian theory is not a comparative one. In fact, there is only one-sided explanation because it considers only the supply side of international trade and completely ignores the demand side. It assumes demand as a given factor. In Professor Olin's words, it is indeed nothing more than an abbreviated account of the conditions of supply. So this is incomplete theory's critic. So next is constant costs. Constant cost, another assumption of the theory is that an increase of output due the international specialization is subject to constant cost. So however, this is incorrect because there is either increasing cost or diminishing cost. Next is factor immobile even in internally. So factor immobile even internally, Ricardo assumes that the factor of production are perfectly mobile, internal, and lack of complete mobility. So complete of mobility internationally means this is unrealistic because even within the country factors lack mobility and do not move freely from one industry to another or from one region to another. So it is seen that greater as specialization in an industry, lesser the mobility of that factor. So with immobility of the factor cost affected and also the pattern of international trade. So student, next is complete specialization impossible. So this critique is the theory of comparative cost has been criticized on the ground that complete division of the labor and specialization in is possible. We illustrate this point by considering two countries of different size, small size and other large size. So student, heterogeneous labor, it means विषम श्रम हे काय एकमेक म्हणजे आळा नाही म्हणजे विषम श्रमाला काय आहे की इथं जो काय एकमेव घटक असतो तो नाही म्हणजे रिकॉर्डने काय केले भांडवल जमीन आणि संयोजक या तीन घटकांचा विचार केला नाही आणि केवळ श्रमाचाच विचार केला असल्यामुळे श्रमाऐवजी सर्व साधन संपत्ती वापराचा संधी खर्च ही संकल्पना काय आहे वापरून या सिद्धांतात मांडता येते इट मीन्स the labor cost theory is based on the assumption homogeneous labor. This cannot be true because labor is heterogeneous, it is different kind, great specialization, etc. So this is a all critical evaluation. And one more is for example, I have one example here. So Bangladesh and India. Bangladesh is a small sized country, you know. So suppose it possesses comparative advantages in jute and India, large size country. India is a large size country in cotton. So Bangladesh will obviously devote its resource to the production of jute. But due to its limited resources, it may be not able to produce jute enough to meet its own and India's requirements. Bangladesh may export some jute to India to pay for its import for cotton from India. However, it failed to meet complete demand of jute for India. It means India will have to produce both cotton as well as jute. India being a large size country cannot specialize in the production of cotton alone. So Bangladesh can't meet India's requirements of jute in full and India specializes in cotton alone. So Bangladesh cannot buy India's entire production of the cotton. So student, a large size country cannot specialize in the commodity alone in which possess a comparative advantages. For example, India in cotton. So it will have to produce both the commodities because the small size country due to its limited resource cannot be the requirement of a large size country in full. So student, the theory of comparative cost in compress some unrealistic and gives rise many wrong and dangerous conclusion, as remarked by Professor Barrett Fell. So it means a follow example of Swedish economics Professor Ohlin, and based a theory of outset a modern conception of value. So this is all over theory, is a recording theory, and recording theory is a very harmful and very explain. So student, theory of comparative cost advantages, and इथंच आपण थांबूया. सो स्टुडंट, नेक्स्ट व्हिडिओ लेट्स अ स्टॉप हियर आवर लेक्चर, अँड नेक्स्ट व्हिडिओ वी विल टीच अ न्यू थेरी. सो थँक्यू सो मच.